Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and under the ages of ages.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
But if he is from above in the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, and the state of the whole churches of God, and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. God preserve Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from their enemies, faithful and invisible, and concern us, one is the mind, brotherly love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Son, into the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto age of ages.
Thank you.
sanctifies and hearken to us.
yet trial of cruel mockings, and scourgings, yes, and of chains and imprisonment. They were sold asunder, were tempted, were slain by the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and mountains, and in dens and caves of the earth. And all these, having obtained the good report through faith, did not receive the promise, God having provided something better for us. That apart from us, they should not be made perfect.
Of the holy, glorious, all-praised apostle and evangelist Matthew, give speech with great power unto thee that bringest good tidings, and the fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Whosoever shall deny me before
not worthy of me, and he that taketh not his cross and follows after me is not worthy of me. Then answered Peter and said to him, Behold, we have forsaken all and followed thee. What shall we have therefore? And Jesus said unto them, Verily I say unto you, that ye which have followed me in the regeneration, when the Son of Man shall sit in the throne of his glory, ye also shall sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone that hath forsaken houses, or brethren, or sisters, or father, or mother, or wife, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, shall receive 100-fold, and shall inherit the everlasting life. But neither the first shall be last, and the last shall be first. И чья Господь своим ученикам, всякий же исповедься мя пред человеке, исповем его я пред Отцем моим, и же на небесех, а иже отвержится мне пред человеке, и отвержится его я пред Отцем моим, и же на небесех. Я же любит отца или мать, паче мне не есть мне достоин, и же любит сына или дочерь, паче мне не есть мне достоин, и же не приемлет креста своего, и вслед мне глядет, не есть мне достоин. Когда приступит к нему это причина, Господи, только отрящий согрешит братьев. Тогда отвечав тебе, речи ему, все мы оставимся, и вслед тебе и духом, что оба будет нам, и служа речей, аминь, благодарю вам, яко вышедший по мне, паки бедье, яко сядет Сын Человеческий на престол славы Своя, сядете вы на десяти престолу судящий, обе на десяти коленам Израилева, и всякий же оставит дом или братья или сестры, или отца, или мать, или жену, или чада, или села, имени моего ради, сторицу примет, и живот вечный следует, мозги же будут первые, последний, последний, первый. Молимся о великом Господине, Отце нашем, святейшем патриарше Кирилле, и о Господине нашем, высокопреосвященнейшем митрополите Илларионе, и о иерархе Пресвятой Церкви, о Господине нашем, преосвященнейшем архиепископе Петре, и все во Христе братии наши. Все молимся о стране всех властях Дома смерти, владычествуя, Господи, не затвори в смерти души рабов Твоих, но пристань от гнева и остави ярость, да не исчезают ягоды дни наши, и еще крепость наша, и погибаем до конца грех ради наших. Милости будь рабом Твоим в покаянии, со слезами молимся, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Я молимся Тебе, Господу Богу нашему, ежи услышится глас моления нашего и молитвы, и помиловать рабу Твою Александру, благодать ее щедротами Твоими, исполни вся прошение ее, и прости вся согрешение вольное и невольное, благоприятным забытым молитвам, милостям я, пред престолом владычестве Твоего и покрытию, под враг видимых и невидимых от всякие напасти, беды и скорби, и будут избавить и подать здравие с долгоденствием. Всем все, Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Тебе, Господу Богу нашему, и за услышите глас моления нас грешных, и помиловать раб Твоих, митрополита Ануфрия, страждущую пасту Его, и Еву Татьяну, Анастасию, Елену, Софию, Серафима, Ирия, Матфея, Рахилю, Василию, Макрину, Эмилию, Софию, Ксению, Подьякона, Адама, Юлианию, Мирицу, Чицамарка, Виктора, Лизавету, Юлию, Михаила, и покрыть их от всякие скорби, гнева и нужды, от всякие болезни душевные и телесные, даровать же им славе с долгоденствием, всем все скоро услыши, и милости вма,
помилуй.
Всемся, Господи, услыши и помилуй. Призри, Владыка, человеколюбцы, на жертвенный подвиг больничных работников наших, возви им здравие, непоколебимая сила и крепость духа, мудрость к совершению трудов по владе народа нашего, и сотвори через них исцеление страждущим рабом Твоим, прилежно молимся, скоро услыши и помилуй. Истинящего пием, ты исцели болезни, урочи страсти, души телес рабов твоих, митрополитов Филариона, Германа и Феодосия, архиепископов Кирилла Петра, епископа Георгия, архимандрита Киева, Серафима Антония, города Ильев Андрея, Михаила Илья, Михаила Сергия, диакона Виталия, рабов Божьих Ольги, Лидии, Натальи, Юлии, Любови, Льва, Татьяны, Юлиани, Анны Николая, Веры, Ольги, Софии, Натальи, Сюсанны, Анны, Софии, Катины, Елизаветы, Виктора, Виктории, Анны, Анастасии, Сугуба, Игумена, Николая, Протерея, Константина, Михаила, Владимира, Владислава, Николая, Протодиакона, Иосифа и Николая, рабов Божих, Ирины, Екатерины и всех болящих святого храма сего, и благость прости им, як уже благосер, вся прегрешение вольное и невольное, и скоро воздвигнет от болезни, молимся, услыши и помилуй. И еще молимся благочащих и добродеющих во святем и всечестнем храме всем, блуждающихся, поющих и предстоящих людях, ожидающих от Тебе великие и богатые милости.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Яко милостивый человек, будет Боге си, Тебе славу воссылаем, Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, ныне и пресно и во веки веков. Господи Иисусе Христе Боже наш, утиши нестроение и распри земли наши американские, отчини от нас клевету и навет, убийство и пьянство, горькие войти и смуту, изгреби в сердцах наших всякую смерть, вражду и злобу, да папи все друг друга возлюбим и почерпим тупно к Тебе, Господи Боже наш, як уже заповедали си и наставили си, мир церкви Твоей и верным чадом я подаш, да единым сердцем и единым юсти, прославим Тебя, Господа и Спасителя нашего, во век и веков. Calm the agitation and discord in our American land. Banish from us slander and conflict, murder and drunkenness, bitter disputes and scandals, and burn out of our hearts every impurity, conflict, and evil, that again we all may love one another and abide as one in Thee, O Lord our God, as Thou hast commanded and directed us. Grant peace to Thy church and to her children, that with one heart and one mouth we may glorify Thee, our Lord and Savior, unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
glory, and of honor for the majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and always, and ages.
As many as the good humans depart,
the humans depart,
as many as the
kept always under thy dominion, we may send up glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
единое Отца нашего, святейшего Кирилла, патриарха Московского и всея Руси, и господина нашего высокопреосвященнейшего Илариона, митрополита Восточноамериканского и Нью-Йоркского, и господина нашего преосвященнейшего Петра, архиепископа Чикагского и Среднеамериканского, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков.
Always now and ever and unto age of age.
Богу хранимую страну российскую и православие людей, облачить свет России несущие, да упоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. Блаженнейшего Ануфрия, митрополита Киевского и Сия в Украине, да упоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. Прилежный воскресенье и жизни вечнее рот своих новопреставленных митрополита Варнави, архиепископа Агапита, скима епископа Петра, Николая, да упоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. Священство, монашество, всех гонимых и страждущих за веру православную, создателей и благотворителей, братьев, сестричества и поющих святого храма сего, и всех вас, православных христиан, да упоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков.
Let us complete our prayer unto the Lord. For the precious gifts set forth, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple and for them that with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter herein, let us pray to the Lord. That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord,
that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Peace, a faithful guide, a gardener of souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon, remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord.
things good and profitable for our souls, and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. May creation end into our life painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Call into remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and the Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Unto all.
Let us love one another that with one mind we may confess. The doors in wisdom, let us attend.
I believe in one God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth and all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ the Son of God,
the only begotten of the Father before all ages,
light of life, true God of true God,
begotten, not made of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from the heavens,
and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man, and was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried and rose on the third day according to the Scriptures, and ascended into the heavens and sitteth at the right hand of the Father, and shall come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, and his kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeded from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, to speak by the prophets, in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand well, let us stand with fear, let us attend, that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
Thank you.
of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary.
Shepard, keep our kingdom most for the common show. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we gather near the parish church to celebrate, thank God, in a beautiful day, a great service of thanksgiving, which is the Eucharist. On this day, we have a universal celebration of the church. Every church celebrates the Sunday of All Saints. Every one of the local churches, whether it be Greek, Russian, Armenian, whatever it is, every local Orthodox church today is celebrating together. All the saints of the universal church. This is a great, great feast of uniting of the Orthodox. And how appropriate it is that we have the opportunity for the first time in about 3 months for all of the clergy of the parish to serve together at the same divine liturgy. It's a real blessing for us, and we're very thankful that we have the opportunity to do that. Last week was the great glorification of the Holy Trinity, the one and only true God whom we worship. Today, we celebrate those who glorified God, the Holy Trinity, all the saints. Principally, this is a feast of the martyrs, and this is why we wear red. Now, practically, tomorrow we're going to change into red anyway because we begin the Apostles' Fast. But this is a feast of the martyrs, and I think it's important for us to remember that. As we celebrate with all of our brothers and sisters in Christ and the whole world, sadly, this is the last day where we'll all be together until we begin the Lenten Triodion again next spring, because we will deviate into our various calendars now, and that's unfortunate, but it's not a canonical issue, it's not a dogmatic question, a question of salvation, and so that happens. We have the blessing, using the traditional church calendar, to always have a 13-day longer fast for the Apostles' Fast than our new calendar friends, and we like that. And sometimes, sadly, they miss, if Pascha is very late, they miss the Apostles' Fast, and we feel bad for them, but we will pray for them. Today, in the Epistle and in the Gospel, we hear about saints, which is probably pretty appropriate, given the fact that we are celebrating the Sunday of All Saints. The Lord, in the Gospel especially, kind of lays out how it is that we can be a saint, how we can attain the heavenly kingdom. And I think it's important for us to understand that the word saint is used in different contexts. St. Paul uses it essentially to talk about all the believers. And then sometimes it's used to talk about anyone who has attained the heavenly kingdom. But when we say Sunday of All Saints, we're talking about those who glorified God on this earth and that God glorified after their repose on the earth. Those for whom, whatever reason, God's grace shines forth even after they have gone on to the next life. And this is important for us. We need this. We have to have examples. We can't just abstractly strive for something abstract in an abstract way. That's not the way that we work. We have to have solid examples that we can follow. Now, the saints are not infallible, right? We could talk for a long time about saints who have written this thing that turns out not to be in accordance with the church and so on and so forth. That's not the point. The point is that they dedicated their lives to the service of God, the Holy Trinity, and God, the Holy Trinity, glorified them after their repose. Why? For them? No, why not? They're in the heavenly kingdom with the other saints. Who cares? Why do they care? For us, to give us an example. Let's look at the Gospel briefly, brothers and sisters. I just wrote down a couple of the verses that I think are really important from today's Gospel, and I want to repeat them and sort of stress them, so that we see what it is that we're striving for. So we see why we're given this example. It's not just to say, yeah, like we are the best, we are saints. No. It's so that we will change our lives and that we will begin to live more like them. The Lord says in today's Gospel from Matthew, whoever shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father who is in heaven. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh up not his cross and followeth me is not worthy of me. I think we often get confused when we hear these verses, and we tend Because we are extremists by nature, that's just the way that we are, we tend to think of the most extreme application of what we're talking about here. So let's look at this. Confess me before men, and I will confess you before my Father who is in heaven. In the most extreme case, we're talking about martyrdom. But there is not really much active martyrdom in the world. There is some, especially in Africa and in Asia, there's some martyrdom. But there's not that much right now, for whatever reason, because I guess we don't need that for our salvation. This mostly has to do with the way that we live our lives. Are we confessing God by the way that we live our lives? Or are we confessing that we are really just secular humanists who like to hang out with, you know, exotic people on Sunday morning? I think the answer cannot be the latter. It has to be the first. We are people of God, not just on Sunday morning, but every single day, all day long. Not, I'm in your face, you know, you have to love Jesus. No. But from our heart, is there shining forth the light of Christ? We can't share what we don't have, so we have to acquire that first. And we do that by struggling within the context, within the structure of the church which the Lord gave us for our salvation. We're given it, the church, so that we can save our souls. And the more that we work on our own salvation, the more we bring others to Christ. Because we don't control that light. That light shines forth upon the people that need to see it. But if we don't have it, it can't shine. So first, brothers and sisters, let's work on ourselves. And then we can better confess God before others by the way that we live our lives. He that loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. The Lord is not saying that we should get rid of our families. I don't think anybody really truly believes that that's what he's saying, and that's not what he's saying. The fathers don't say that's what he's saying. He's saying, you have to put God first. God's number one. Neighbor's number two. I'm number three. That's what this is saying. God has to be first. If we don't have God first in our lives, then everything's upside down. We can never confess God before others if we haven't got that part figured out first. So let's reflect on that, brothers and sisters, and see where we are there. And he that taketh up not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. Again, we often think about martyrdom, and that's not wrong. But for most of us, what that means is thankfully accepting what the Lord gives us in our lives because we understand that it's best for our salvation. It may not be what we want. Right? God is not the great genie of wishes. God gives us what we need. And bearing that, not grumbling, thanking God, because he is giving us what's best, even if it doesn't comport with what's convenient or what we want, this is bearing our cross. And this is something that we all have to work on every single day. Bearing our cross, confessing God before others, and making sure that God is number one in our lives. And if we do that, brothers and sisters, then we are like the saints that we celebrate today. This ancient icon of, not ancient in that it's painted a million years ago, the design is very old, of all saints, where we have Christ in the middle of the universe, surrounded by all the saints. This is kind of a vision. This is a, gives us an idea in our sort of carnal mind what heaven is like. God is on the high throne, and all the saints surround him and sing his praises and share his love. This, brothers and sisters, is what we're striving for. And so before you leave today, try to get a real nice, strong mental picture of that icon in your mind. Or if you're like me, take a picture with your cell phone because your mind won't hold it. That's fine. And look at that every now and then, especially when it seems like you're having trouble putting God first in your life, or you're having trouble confessing God before others, or you're having trouble bearing your cross, as the Lord asks us to do. Recall the icon, or open it on your phone, and look at that, and think about those people that came before us. We hear about the martyrs in the epistle especially, and how they gave up their lives for Christ. In a way, we're being asked to do that too. Not physically to give up our lives, but to put Christ first in our life, and to follow after the saints. The saints trod the path to the heavenly kingdom. And they trod it down, they trod it enough that we can see where it is that we have to go. Let's decide, brothers and sisters, that today we're going to follow that path. We're going to do our best. And when we fall, we're going to get up, dust ourselves off, and keep walking along that path, asking God's help all the way. If we can do that, then today we have really received the good news, the evangelium of the gospel, the real love of God. Let us, brothers and sisters, strive to attain it and strive to share it. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Страхом Божиим и верою приступите.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who camest into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first. I believe also that this is truly thine own most pure body, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore, I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mystery to thine enemies, neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss. But like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen.
Верю, Господи, исповедую, яко ты есть во истину Христос, Сын Бога живого, пришедший в мир грешный спасти, а нынче первый есмь аз. Еще верю, яко се самое пречистое тело Твое, и сия самая честная кровь Твоя. Молюсь об Тебе, помяни меня и прости мне прегрешение мое, вольное и невольное, даже словом и же делом, и же ведением и неведением. Исправь меня неосужденно, причаститеся, причисти Твой таинств, во оставлении грехов в жизнь вечную. Аминь. Вечери Твои тайны, Сыне Божий, причастника и причастницу меня приими, не во врагом Твоим тайно повем, не во отзами Тебе дам, як у Юда, но и кровозвойник исповедую Тебя, помяни меня, Господи, во Царстве Твоем. Да не в суде либо осуждение, но время причащения святых Твоих тайн, Господи, на исцеление души и тела. Аминь.
Brothers and sisters, in the pandemic we partake slightly differently than we do outside of the pandemic. We will not wipe your lips when you come to partake of Holy Communion unless there's some very specific reason we need to do that. And you will not kiss the chalice. If you would like to have the spoon sanitized before you commune, you're going to tell Mark, the very good-looking man here waving his arm at you, when you come to the head of the line, he'll be there, and he'll alert me, because I don't pause between people, and that's my fault. It's very important for us to understand, you cannot get sick from Holy Communion. It's absolutely impossible. But we understand that for some folks, it's a temptation about the chalice and the cloth and the spoon, and that's fine. This is not outside the practice of the church. St. Nicodemus of the Holy Mountain talks about this in the 28th explanation of the 28th canon of the 6th Ecumenical Council, and I know you all know that because you've memorized that, and so we have the opportunity to do it. We don't force it. It's an option. So if you'd like to exercise that option, you just tell Mark, and we'll make sure that we do that for you.
Oh, yes. Please try to spread out a little bit. Servant of God, subject in call in, predicts the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and permission of sins and life everlasting. Servant of God, read our mark, predicts the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and permission of sins and life everlasting. Preacher, очищает раб Божий, чтец Дмитрий, честной строитель и крови, Господи, Боже, спас нашего Иисуса Христа, в оставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Очищает раб Божий, Даниил, честной строитель и крови, Господи, Боже, спас нашего Иисуса Христа, в оставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Очищает раб Божий, Александр, честной строитель и крови, Господи, Боже, спас нашего Иисуса Христа, в оставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. You have to be in front of them. If you're over there, it's already too late. Причащается раба Божия Мария, честная своя тела и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, вставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Анастасия, честная своя тела и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, вставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Серафима, честная своя тела и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, вставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Александра, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раб Божий Константин, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, и в жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Анна, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раб Божий Анатолий, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов и в жизнь вечную. Все. Не надо целовать. Причащает the handmaiden of God, Catherine, partakes the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, remission of sins and life everlasting. Handmaiden of God, Genevieve, partakes the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, remission of sins and life everlasting. Причащается раб Божий Дмитрий, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов и в жизнь вечную. Servant of God Paisie partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and remission of sins and life everlasting. There you go. Hold on. Handmaiden of God Ruth partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and remission of sins and life everlasting. Servant of God Isidore partakes the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and permission of sins and life everlasting. Servant of God John partakes the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and permission of sins and life everlasting. Servant of God Joseph partakes the most precious and holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ and permission of sins and life everlasting. Причащается раб Божий Андрей, честное строитель и крови, Господа и Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехом, жизнь вечную. Причащается раб Божий Иоанн, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Ангелина, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Все. Причащается раба Божия Елена, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Анастасия, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Светлана, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Светлана, честное строитель Плотиния, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Handmaiden of God, Madeline, partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, in remission of sins and life everlasting. Mark, if you can get a little closer to the bricks so they kind of see you there, that's helpful. Причащается раба Божия Светлана, честная строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, и в жизнь вечную. Handmaiden of God, Maria, partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, and to the remission of sins and life everlasting. Pull the mass bind, pull the hand. Причащается раба Божия Маргарита, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Все. Причащается раба Божия Василиса, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов и в жизнь вечную. Причащается раба Божия Татьяна, честное строитель и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. Все. Причащается раба Божия Мария, честная строителя и крови, Господи Бога и спаси нашего Иисуса Христа, восставленный грехов, жизнь вечную. очищає це раба Божа Марія, чесної старі тіла і крові, Господа і Бога і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, обставлений духом і жизнь вечною. Очищається раба Божа Анна, чесна старі тіла і крові, Господа і Бога і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, обставлений духом і жизнь вечною. Очищається раба Божа Ксенія, чесна старі тіла і крові, Господа і Бога і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, обставлений духом і жизнь вечною. Повинуємо. Очищається раб Божий Михаїл, чесно старітела і крові, Господи Бог і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, вставлений духом, жизнь вечною. Make sure the grass that's in your sister's mouth gets put into a veterinary place. Очищається раб Божий Николай, чесно старітела і крові, Господи Бог і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, вставлений духом, жизнь вечною. Очищається раб Божий Григорій, чесно старітела і крові, Господи Бог і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, вставлений духом, жизнь вечною. Очищається the servant of God Michael, partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, and remission of sins and life everlasting. Очищається раба Божа Іоанна, чесна старі тіла і крові, Господа і Бога і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, обставлений гріхом, жизнь вечною. Очищається раба Божа Ксенія, чесна старі тіла і крові, Господа і Бога і спаси нашого Ісуса Христа, обставлений гріхом, жизнь вечною. Очищається раба Божа the servant of God Алексей, partakes the most precious holy body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, the remission of sins and life everlasting.
Taken of the divine, holy, most immortal, heavenly, and life-giving, fearful mysteries of Christ, let us worthy give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having us that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and safe.
who blesses those who bless thee, and sanctify those who trust in thee, save thy people, and bless thy inheritance, preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house, glorify them who return by the divine power, and forsake us not, and put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy church, and to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Ancestors of God, who came in Anna and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and the lover of mankind. Поздравляю всех причастников, congratulations to everyone who took the Holy Communion. Поздравляю всех праздником, congratulations to everyone with the feast. We want to welcome everyone as we begin to come back to church and gather together. It's nice to be able to see everyone, and we want you to also feel free to invite friends. It's a little bit of an odd introduction to the church, I suppose, but this is just our reality now. So if we wait till we get back to normal, we weren't very normal before, and I'm not sure we'll ever be normal again, so please begin to invite people, especially those that you know are interested. Speaking of returning to normal, beginning on July 12th, the Feast of Peter, St. Peter and Paul, will have our first parish meal, and we'll of course follow all of the appropriate precautions. But if you'd like to sort of give us your ideas about that ahead of time, you'd be welcome to do that. We'll have a Google Doc out there that you can anonymously post ideas. You can always send an email to our head sister, or any of our sisterhood officers, and you can talk to them today. Or write something down on a piece of paper and hand it to them. We want to know what you think so that we do this as best as possible and as safely as possible. The church is open for public worship during the week. We have the services inside, and we have a limited number of spaces where people can be, so we ask you to sign up ahead of time just so that we don't have a conflict. So far, there hasn't been any conflicts. We're not planning on using any of that information for those of you who are very concerned about contact tracing And if you are, please talk to me, because I'll be happy to tell you about it. I did it for quite a long time with infection control at the University of Michigan. But that's not the issue. We want to just make sure that we don't have competition for spaces. If there's some kind of outbreak, if somebody gets sick, we're going to let you all know when, right? We're going to let you know that somebody got sick so that you can take the right steps. I want to announce something. You know, during our pandemic, everything is kind of crazy, and everything is new, and everything is different, and we hate change, and so on and so forth. You may remember all those many years ago when it was Great Lent, that Colin was going to be ordained a deacon by Archbishop Peter. He was planning to come, but that couldn't happen because of the quarantine. And Lodipa has decided to ordain Colin a deacon on June 28th at the Diocese in Cathedral. That's two Sundays from now. That will also be the Sunday of graduation from the pastoral school, and God willing, Colin will be graduating then. So we want to congratulate him, and we want to congratulate Katie and Mac, and we want everyone to be very supportive and helpful. Especially to Katie and Mac, it's not that they so much lose their dad and their husband, but it's a slightly different paradigm, and it's important that we all be supportive. And we should all be very thankful that the Lord is blessing us to have another server at the altar in our parish. So congratulations, Colin, to you and to Katie, and let us all, brothers and sisters, pray that Colin will have a long time of service in the Lord's vineyard beginning here at St. Vladimir's. What we will probably do, I still have to look at all the details of the week, but most likely that week, which is the week that leads up to July 4th, we'll have services every week here at St. Vladimir's. The practice is when someone is in the world with a job and so on and so forth, that you try to serve at least 7 days in a row. In the monastery, we got to serve 40 days in a row. That was great. But we don't have that kind of capacity, but we're going to try to do that. So for those of you who are helping during the pandemic a lot for the singing and the reading, don't open emails from me, because I'm going to be asking you to do the same for that week especially. And we'll all get to enjoy and participate in those divine services. So something good and wonderful for us to be able to announce here during our pandemic. In Michigan, our numbers are going down, thank God for that. But we can't be lazy about it. We can't rest on our laurels. So it's not that the virus is not in the community anymore. And so be careful. Be smart. You know, think about what you're doing. Think about who you're with. And try not to spread the virus. If you have questions about that, you can talk to me. I'll send you to one of our nurses or doctors, and they'll tell you everything that you want to know and 10 times more about what you should and shouldn't do. And that's okay. It's good for us to be educated, and we should be doing our best to try to defeat the virus with the rest of our community, with the rest of our society. It's made it possible for us to have many divine services this week. We aren't quite doing it every day anymore, now that the quarantine is weakened, but we're still serving off, and we're very thankful for that. And it helps everyone in the parish, whether you can be at the services or not, when we have the divine services. The services for this week you can find in our Sunday reading, and we're going to be handing that out here. I guess the laser printer got very excited that we were all back together again, because I asked for 10 copies and they gave me 9 of them. I finally had to stop. It just was like a 25. So there's a lot, and we don't want to waste them. So take it with you, please, especially if you haven't taken Sunday reading before. There's always articles about today's feast, what's happening on the Sunday, and about what's coming up in the week. It also has the schedule for the coming week. For instance, we have liturgy on Wednesday morning. So it'd be good to know all of those things. So please take that when you come to visit for us. We have to take this for us when you receive the empty door today. Please remember our brother, Nick Lucidius, who passed away. The 40th day for Nick is July 4th. And unless something strange happens, because Colin is going to be ordained, we're going to have liturgy that day, so that's nice. We'll have a memorial liturgy, and we'll be able to serve the 40th day of Panakiva for Nick. So please keep Nick in your prayers, and Julia, too, who's suffering at her loss, and try to be as supportive as you can to Julia during this time. Remember that the Apostles' Fast begins tomorrow. I know I mentioned it in the sermon, but that's kind of plausible deniability. Not everybody listens to the sermon, and not everybody listens to the announcements, but hopefully you listen to one of the two. Tomorrow we begin the Apostles' Fast. As with all of the fasting periods, we abstain from meat and dairy products. But this is a pretty, it's not a super strict fast. There's a lot of days when you can have fish. And it's good to look at the calendar, which is you can find here in Sunday reading at the bottom of the first page, and it tells you what the fasting rules are for each day. You can also find that on our website on the full calendar, which is there. Just look for current calendar when you go to the homepage. See me or Father Moses if you have questions about fasting. Fasting is for everybody. There's nobody that doesn't fast. But sometimes, you know, when your conditions of your life may make it important for you. For instance, if you're starting to fast, we can help you how to do that. Or something is going on, we can help you. So Please talk to us about that so that you're able to participate in the fast and prepare yourself for the Feast of St. Peter and Paul on July 12th. That's when the fast ends. It's a Sunday this year. Thank God that works out really nicely. As I mentioned, we'll have a meal. We'll also be a wedding that day. So it's going to be a really nice day at St. Vladimir's, and more information will be coming out about that. We have cemetery spaces available, and thank God for that. It was the 40th day for Dimitri Kunitsch's grandmother on Friday, handing of God Alexandra, and please do remember her in your prayers as well. And she's buried at the cemetery. It's so nice when you go gather there on a beautiful day. The wind was blowing a little bit in from the highway, so we had a little highway noise, but that was okay. Nobody complained, and we were able to be together right by the church and to pray for the repose right where she's buried. So that's really nice, and I think you want that for yourself too. At least I hope you do. I know I do. And if you'd like to learn more about that, you can see Jack today, or you can see Constantine. They can tell you a little bit more about that. Are there other announcements? Oh, yes, very important. Are you going to talk about the cans? No. You can and bottle drive. Would you like to take your cans and bottles back to Meyer? You can't, because they won't let you do that. But we'll take them. So we sent that information earlier this week. We know that you looked at that, and you've all got trunks and trucks and all kinds of things full of cans and bottles. We have our parish truck out on the parking lot here, the handicap parking lot. Just throw it in the back. Just throw it in the back, and we'll be very happy to take care of that for you. We'll take care of those when it's possible to bring unlimited amounts of cans and bottles back. We'll do that, and that'll benefit the church, and we'll get off your hands. And if you forgot, you can do that next week too. Constantine, with an announcement, you'll have to use the microphone.
Who? This is the information for our brothers. I understand it's not for everyone this year, but I hope that we will reach the rest of our brothers via email. So, first, this coming Saturday, we will have a first work party in this season. Officially, we are allowed to work together with some precautions, masks at least tonight. No gloves. Now, we have already tiles and sand here prepared for a repair or to continue to repair our sidewalk. And that's what we will do this Saturday. More information will come in email. Please watch your emails every day. There will be changes, maybe. And of course, we depend on the weather. If the weather is not acceptable, then we will cancel it. Second, these tents now will be stored not inside the church, but in the small shed, which we have right here. You know where it is.
At the end of the parking lot.
Yes, at the end of the parking lot. So, beginning today, of course, we'll put them out there. And the third is that I need two brothers today, right at the end of the service, for 10, no more than 10 minutes of work. It won't be a dirty work. Just move a couple of things. Please, come to me. Want to participate. This is it. Thank you.
Yes, I need to announce, you know, life goes on, even in the quarantine and pandemic. We'll have a baptism on next Sunday after the Divine Liturgy. And so they wanted to know that, and they're welcome to stay after the two. We don't have a meal quite yet, but we'll have the baptism right after the Divine Liturgy. Another thing that we can rejoice in, even in these odd times. Other announcements. All right, so let's listen to the Thanksgiving prayers after communion as we come to receive the Antidor. And please keep in mind, brothers and sisters, that we have lots of Sunday readings here. The boys will hand them to you. You'll have to physically keep them from giving it to you, so please take it. And please have a read and engage yourself spiritually during the upcoming Apostles' Fast. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee, our God, glory to thee, our God. you, Lord my God, because you have not rejected me, a sinner, but have counted me worthy to be a communicant of your holy things. I thank you because you have counted me the unworthy, worthy to share your most pure in heaven. Gifts, the master lover of mankind, who died for our sake, and rose again, who gave us these, your all-inspiring and life-giving mysteries, granted these gifts, may bring me also here my soul and body, the repelling of every adversary, who invite me to be eyes of my heart, peace of my spiritual powers, faith unashamed, love without pretense, fullness of wisdom, the keeping of your commandments, increase of your divine grace, and the gaining of your kingdom, that preserved through them by your sanctification, and I always remember your grace, and no longer live for myself, but for you, our Master and Benefactor. And so when I leave this present life in the hope of life eternal, I shall find everlasting repose, where the sound of those who feast is unceasing, and the delight of those who see the ineffable beauty of your face is unbounded. For you are the true desire and the inexpressible joy of those who love you, Christ our God, and our creation, hymns you to the ages. Amen.
Владыка, Христе Божий, царю веков, свидетеля всех, благодарю тебя всех, нежели и сего дар благих, и от очищения причинных, уже творящих твоих тайн. Молю бы тебя, блажен человека любче, сохрани меня под кровом твоими, всеми крылью твоею, и даруй мне чистую совесть, и даже до последнего моего издыхания, достойно посещайте со святыми твоих, восставление грехов и жизнь вечную. Ты бы иди, хлеб животный, источник святыми податель благих, и тебе славу посылаю со всем святым духом.
You willingly give me your flesh for food, you are a fire consuming the unworthy. Do not burn me up, my maker, but penetrate the structure of my limbs, all my joints, my inner parts, my heart. Burn up the thorns of all my offenses. Purify my soul and sanctify my mind. Strengthen my knees together with my bones, enlighten the fivefold simpleness of my senses, nail down the whole of me with the fear of you, always protect, guard, and keep me from every soul-destroying deed and word, hallow me, purify me, bring me to harmony, and give me beauty, understanding, light, show me to be your dwelling, the Spirit's house alone, and no more the dwelling place of sin, that by the entrance of communion, every evildoer, every passion may flee from me, your house, as from fire. As intercessors, I bring you all the saints, the companies of the bodiless hosts, your forerunner, the wise apostles, and with them, your most pure and holy mother. Accept their prayers, O my compassionate Christ, and make your worshiper a child of light. For you alone are the sanctification of our souls, O good one, and the brightness and fitting me to you as to our God and Master, we give praise and glory every day.
Сделай святой Господи Иисусе Христе Боже наш, да будет мир же возвечный, кровь твоя честная, восставление грехов. Буди же мне благодарение все, радость, здравие, веселье, страшное жертвы, пришествие Твое, с подобием грешного, стать одесную славу Твою я, молитва пречистая Твою Матери всех святых.
Аминь. All holy Lady Theotokos, the light of my darkened soul, my hope, protection, refuge, comfort, joy, I thank you because you have made me the unworthy, worthy to become a partaker in the most pure body and precious blood of your Son. But, O you who gave birth to the true light, enlightened the spiritual eyes of my heart, you who bore the source of immortality, give life to me, who has been slain by sin. You, the compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me, give me compunction and contrition in my heart, humility in my ideas, and release from the imprisonment of my thoughts, and count me worthy until my last breath to receive without condemnation the sanctification of the most pure mysteries for healing of soul and body, and grant me tears of repentance and thanksgiving to praise and glorify you all the days of my life, for you are blessed and glorified to the ages. Amen.
Ныне отвечаешь раба твоего, владыка, по глаголу твоему с миром, яко видишь то очи мои спасение твое, еже и сил готова пред лице всех людей, светлое откровение языков и славы людей твоих Израиля. Святый Божий, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Божий, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Святый Божий, святый крепкий, святый бессмертный, помилуй нас. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу и ныне, присно во веки веков. Аминь. Пресвятая Троица, помилуй нас. Господи, очисти грехи наши, владыка, прости беззаконие наши. Святый, посети истины немощи наши, имени Твоего ради. Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй. Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно во веки веков. Аминь. Отче наш, же и си на небесе, да святится имя Твое, да придет Царствие Твое, да будет воля Твоя, яко на небесе и на земле. Хлеб наш насущный дашь нам днесь, и остави нам долги наши, яко же и мы оставляем должником нашим. И не веди нас во искушение, но избави нас от лукавого.
И славу Отца и Сына и Святого Духа, и ныне и присно во веки веков.
The grace which shone forth from your mouth like a torch of flame enlightened the whole earth. It laid up for the world the treasures of freedom from avarice. It showed us the height of humility. But as you train us by your word, Father John Chrysostom, intercede with Christ God the Word that our souls may be saved.
Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, от небес приялась и божественную благодать, и Твоими устами вся учишь и поклоняйтесь в Троице единому Богу Иоанне Златоусте всеблажений, преподобие достойно хвалим Тя, истиго наставник, яко божественное являя.
Both now and ever and unto the ages of ages, Amen. O protection of Christians that cannot be put to shame, O mediation unto the Creator unfailing, disdain not the suppliant voices of sinners. But be thou quick, O good one, to help us who in faith cry unto thee. Hasten to intercession and speed thou to make supplication. Thou who dost ever protect, O Theotokos, them that honor thee.
Господи помилуй, 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 Господи помилуй.
Премудрого Пресвятая Богородица, спаси нас.
Честнейшую Херувим и славнейшую без сравнения Серафим, без освящения Бога Словородшую, сущую Богородицу Тебя величаем.
Слава Тебе, Христе Божие, упование наше, слава Тебе.
Слава Отцу и Сыну и Святому Духу, и ныне и присно во веки веков. Аминь. Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, благослови.
Воскреси из мертвых, Христос истинный Бог наш, молитвами пречистая Своей Матери, и же во святых Отца нашего Иоанна, архиепископа Константина, града Златоустого и всех святых, помилует и спасет нашего благ и человеку. Поздравляю всех с воскресным днем. Congratulations to everyone with the small Pascha, which is every Sunday.